6,919,377,000 of us live on this tiny planet, and only a few of us can see the connections. The patterns, mathematical in design, are hidden in plain sight. Just have to know where to look.
The Fibonacci sequence is named after Leonardo of Pisa, who is known as Fibonacci. Leonardo was born in the 12th century, 1170 to 1250. He was an Italian mathematician who was known for rediscovering the numeral system in the Fibonacci sequence. He was also responsible for spreading the Hindu-Arabic numeral system. The Fibonacci sequence is a sequence of numbers. Each number is the sum of the previous two numbers. The sequence starts with 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, and so on. As the sequence continues, the numbers get larger. So basically, the 15th number will be in the hundreds. A visual two-dimensional representation of this ratio would look like this. This ratio is called the golden mean, golden section, and it's also known as the 3x5 ratio. You can see the 3x5 ratio in everyday life. It is in nature, art, architecture, and is reflected in the human body. The 3x5 ratio was known by the Greeks. It was believed to be the most beautiful ratio. Another visual, the golden ratio. This time, the rectangles are turned to its side in a shape which is called the golden spiral. The golden spiral can be seen in various places in life and in life itself. Some of the world's famous artists use this method in their paintings, artists such as Leonardo da Vinci. Many 20th century architects used the golden ratio in the construction of their structures. Here are some examples where the golden spiral can be seen. You will see the golden spiral in any shell. In the arms of spiral galaxies, you can notice the golden ratio take place. The golden spiral can also be seen in the formation of hurricanes. There is an important number relating to the Fibonacci sequence called phi. Any number in the sequence of numbers multiplied by phi results in the next number. The number phi looks like this: 1.618033988. And the number keeps going on. To make things more simple, I'll be shortening the number to 1.618. For example, if you multiply 13 by 1.618, you would get the next number in the sequence. Each number in the sequence is roughly 1.618 times bigger than the last number.
You know, like the Fibonacci sequence?
That's like that series you find in nature? Like the face of a sunflower?
Where are the spirals?
You see this math everywhere.
The quantum unit, if you like, the real basics of the universe, quantum physics thinks, are a quark, okay?
Right.
A quark, a single unit, a single nothing. A quark is made up of two units which vibrate.
Yes.
Okay, think of our light and our sound that we were talking about earlier on, okay?
Got
because
that.
They vibrate, they are pure energy, pure frequency.
Right.
But they give the impression of being matter by creating the vibration, which creates a physical response.
As you know, Mother Nature uses all kinds of mathematical languages. That when we go to understand physical phenomena, we generally find that there's some sort of mathematical underpinning to whatever the phenomena is.
How did we end up in a universe like that?
Why should the world behave according to mathematical laws?
And it turns out, in fact, all of our senses appear to rely on sort of Fourier transforms, that they all seem to use the same mathematics. So again, here's evidence that the brain uses the same mathematics to decipher the sensory world as are involved in the making of a hologram, mm-hmm. which is, as I say, not proof, but compelling evidence that something is going on there.
Not only that it becomes easier to describe with mathematics, as you go deeper and deeper into reality, mathematics becomes the only way to describe reality.
Dude, what was the song that you did to the Fibonacci sequence?
Now you're on drugs.
He's beautiful. He's beautiful in what he is. You can't fake a Brian. I mean, he is just that. That's who he is.
Yeah, there's no.
What was the song that you did to the Fibonacci sequence?
I believe it was Foggy Mountain Breakdown.
Really?
No. It was one of those songs.
One of those songs.
Yeah.
Whatever it is, you can find it online. Google it. But the Fibonacci sequence. I watched a documentary about it once, where they showed pine cones and pineapples and sunflowers and all these different, and show that there's some sort of a mathematical code to nature.
Right, and I think the funny thing is, like, people like myself actually trying to, like, force those numbers on a song. It's kind of funny. It's kind of clunky because the song is that. Any song is that. So, you know, to kind of, like,
force, is that it, Brian?
Force these. No, it's like, you know, my kid playing with blocks. Like, oh, look, they're square and they stack. Everything is that. So to, like, actually, like,
right, your face is that.
Force that into a song is a little soft work. So I'm reprimanding myself for being a little silly.
Oh, you're not. You were. I thought it was an homage to the order of the universe. I didn't think it was silly at all. Mm. But that's as a fan. Mm. I enjoyed it. But I
it was just short for fanatic, and I have to go now.
That's why, you know, you look at someone with a nose job and you go, "What the fuck is going on here? Something's
you've
wrong."
You've ruined the sequence.
Yeah, you've ruined the Fibonacci sequence. Mm-hmm. You know, you got to make lemons out of lemonade. You got to make soup out of the ham hocks and the beans that you've been given. And it just is what it is. When you really find out that it truly is a mathematical sequence that the whole universe is based on, it's one of those things that really makes you step back and go, we might as well be fucking cavemen. Because even though we like to think that with our 4G connections and our satellite dishes and our cars that we somehow or another have elevated from the biological, like, boy, we're still so base. We're still so stuck in the rut of the mud. Mm-hmm. You know, we really have barely wrapped our heads around how complicated and insane and diverse this whole thing really is.
Mm-hmm.
And the Fibonacci sequence, to me, is like one of those real, real mind fucks that makes you just pause. And there was a particle physicist recently, or a theoretical physicist, that was talking about when they study quantum mechanics, they find that there's some sort of an embedded code to it all, that it's not just an embedded code, it's a recognizable code that is used in mathematicians. And they said, look, this fucking, the whole universe is a program. Mm. Like, it's a program. You know, whether you call it, whether it's a biological program or whether there's intelligent design and it's been done by some engineer, like from Prometheus movie, whatever it is, there's a program to this.
Right. And you know, I was always playing around with a story where you actually, the only way to time travel would be to somehow connect into the base of your DNA. And there's actually a time code in the DNA, and you have to, like, reset it so that all of a sudden you just end up in this other, you know, time zone. But then your software wouldn't be compatible. So this whole script fell apart just before my eyes.
Okay, so 1, 1, 2, 3, 5. That's the beginning of the Fibonacci sequence. Next number in the sequence, what do you think? How about 8? The number after that, 13. The number after that, 21. So if you're getting those right along with me, then you've recognized the pattern that I wrote with the first few numbers in the Fibonacci sequence, which is this. It starts with a 1, the next number's a 1, then after that, to get the next number, you'll always add the two numbers that came before that. So 1 and 1 is 2, 1 and 2 is 3, 2 and 3 is 5, 3 and 5 is 8, so on and so forth. So that's recognizing the pattern that exists in the Fibonacci sequence. So it turns out that this sequence of numbers has all kinds of applications. It describes all kinds of things in the world that we see around us.
There's a conspiracy to hide this information that DNA is a Fibonacci, is an exemplification of this number or entity ratio sequence called the golden ratio, the ratio that proves the existence of intelligent design, or the reality of intelligent design of the cosmos. I mean, if you go to the golden ratio site for Wikipedia too on the same theme, they don't mention any of this stuff in Nature that we're going to talk about here, that we talked about in the show 2 days ago, and that we're talking about here. They talk about how it's found in architecture and math and all this kind of stuff. They don't discuss it, how it's found in the measurements of the human arm. Why not? I think I'm making, that's the point here. I think that just made sense to me, thinking this through as I say it to you. It has to be a conspiracy. How could all of this be overlooked, and how could Wikipedia leave it out? It can't be, there has to be somehow that big money has pushed their influence somehow, and they've had a drive to keep this covered up or something. These can't all be coincidences. And since they're doing that with everything else, it has to be the case that there's some movement to keep this stifled. I mean, why isn't, and here's another piece to add to this, why isn't this in our education system? We learn all this junk geometry, pea brain stuff, when you take geometry in high school, and they don't teach you about any of this? The golden ratio everywhere in nature? I went through elementary school, you know, high school, college, undergrad degree in college, master's degree, and halfway through PhD, and never was this, any of this mentioned. And we know who controls the universities, the big money behind it, all the way up to the Illuminati Nephilim controllers. So this can't be, this is planned, okay? And you just wonder, it's got to, I mean, I'm almost concluding here in my mind, this Davidson College site showing up number one in Google all the time and first page, and Wikipedia having these strange measurements which don't correlate with all kinds of these examples from academic sites I'm finding, and I'm putting them all, pictures of the screenshots in the newsletter. It's got to be a conspiracy. I mean, we could keep going compiling the evidence, it would just all lead to it. So, and if we could keep compiling evidence of it being a conspiracy, I mean, everything points towards it. I'm just throwing ideas off the top of my head. These strange sites show up at the top. Wikipedia is wrong. It's covered up completely in the best-selling books about the golden ratio, which come from wealthy university professors. It's the universities and education, government-controlled education system absolutely covers it up. You see how, I mean, everything's falling in the same direction. You know, so when everything, all these conclusions point to the same direction, that it's covered up and hidden.
Individuality, the trademark of any artist, designer, or architect. Each desires a uniqueness to their creation, a quality that separates it from any other. Man naturally has this individuality, his fingerprint. There are 6.5 billion people on the face of the earth, and no two fingerprints are the same. Everything we touch or make contact with is branded with a small expressed image revealing to all who see it who was there. Around 1200 AD, a man named Leonard Pisano, better known as Fibonacci, discovered a sequence of numbers that created a very interesting pattern. The sequence begins with the numbers 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, and continues indefinitely. Each number is obtained by adding the last two digits together. A rectangle with a length and width of any two of the numbers of this sequence forms what is known as the golden rectangle, a perfect rectangle. A golden rectangle can be broken down into squares the size of the next Fibonacci numbers down and below. If we were to take a perfect or golden rectangle, break it down into smaller squares based on Fibonacci sequence, and divide each with an arc, the patterns begin to take shape. We begin to see Fibonacci's spiral. The spiral in and of itself is insignificant. Its importance is revealed in where we find it. Take, for example, the sunflower. The display of its florets are in perfect spirals of 55, 34, and 21, the sequence of Fibonacci. The fruitlets of the pineapple create the same spiral based on the sequence. The pine cone does the same. As currents move through the ocean and the tide rolls onto the shore, the waves that bring in the tide curve into a spiral that can be mathematically diagrammed onto a plot at the points 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, and 55. Buds on trees, sand dollars, starfish, petals on flowers, and especially the nautilus shell are formed with this exact same blueprint. With each segment of growth, the nautilus adds to itself one more value on Fibonacci's scale. This blueprint can be seen around us on a small scale every day, but the greatest example of all is directly above our heads. At an average of 100,000 light years across, even the spiral of the galaxies above us are formed with the exact design that the tiny shell is formed. This sequence, or blueprint, appears to be the trademark of a designer, a proof of a creator, something left behind indicating the one who was there, a fingerprint. As we scan our universe from the tiny flower to the awe-inspiring galaxy, we see the fingerprint of God.
The whole conception of nature is as a self-regulating, self-governing, indeed democratic organism. But it has a totality. It all goes together, and this totality is the Tao. When we speak in Taoism of following the course of nature, following the way, what it means is more like this. Doing things in accordance with the grain. It doesn't mean you don't cut wood, but it means that you cut wood along the lines where wood is most easy to cut.
Look at your hand. Not only does each finger have its own ratio moving up each finger, which is 5 to the next bone, but it oscillates back and forth from the tallest finger to the thumb. You wonder why the human hand is like that? It's based on phi. This relationship is found throughout the body in various ways, moving up the arms and legs, in your face, throughout the entire body. Here is the phi ratio in butterflies. You can see this ratio everywhere, from the wing size to the body to the antennas. They're all phi ratios. Here's dragonflies. It's the same story. Phi runs along the entire body and the relation to the body and the wings. Here it is in frogs. Phi is found throughout the body in relation to the head, to the arms, to the fingers, and so on. It doesn't just apply to these creatures though. Regardless of what mammal, insect, avian, plant, or living creature of any kind, you will find this ratio one way or another. However, phi has no beginning and no end. Life doesn't know how to deal with that. It's like Source says, go and replicate this, and life says, we don't know how. Because life doesn't know how to create from something that has no beginning. So it creates the Fibonacci sequence instead, which has a beginning, but starts out crude, very basic, and then continually goes closer and closer to Source, becoming more divine every step. Now the Fibonacci sequence is life's way of creating the golden mean. Allow me to explain. This sequence is continually made from adding the previous number to the current. 1 and 1 is 2, 2 and 1 is 3, 3 and 2 is 5, 5 and 3 is 8. You can see how it continues. Now what most people don't know about Fibonacci is that it actually continually strives closer and closer to the phi ratio. By dividing the current number into the last, you can see this happening. 1 into 1 is 1. 2 into 1 is 2. 3 into 2 is 1.5. 5 into 3 is 1.666. Continuing with that, it's 1.6, and then 1.625, 1.615384, 1.619048, and so on. It continually oscillates over and under the phi ratio, never quite making it there, but continuing on closer and closer every time, until eventually you can't even tell the difference. Because phi is an infinite number, this sequence will go on forever.
You have to see that life, that the so-called conflict of various species with each other, is not actually a competition. It's a very strange system of interrelationship, of things feeding on each other and cultivating each other at the same time.
Take, for example, this incredible image of a supercomputer simulation known as the Millennium Run, showing the distribution of dark matter in the local universe. It was created by the Max Planck Society in Germany. Dark matter is essentially what we previously thought of as empty space. It is like an invisible nervous system that runs throughout the universe. The universe is literally like a giant brain. It is constantly thinking, using a type of dark or hidden energy that science is only starting to understand. Through this immense network, unfathomable energy moves, providing the momentum for the expansion and growth of the universe.
Computers, math.
Math? What kind of math?
Number theory. Research, what? Mostly.
No way, I work with numbers myself. I mean, not traditional. I work with the Torah. Amazing! You know, Hebrew's all math. It's all numbers. You know that? Yeah, look. The ancient Jews used Hebrew as their numerical system, man. Each letter's a number. Like the Hebrew A, Aleph, it's one. B, bet, it's 2. You understand? But look at this. The numbers are interrelated. Like, take the Hebrew word for father. Av, Aleph, bet. 1, 2, equals 3. All right? Hebrew word for mother, aim, Aleph, mem, 1, 40, equals 41. Sum of 3 and 41, 44. All right? Now, Hebrew word for child. All right? Mother, father, child. Yelad. That's 10, 30, and 4. 44. Torah is just a long string of numbers. Some say that it's a code sent to us from God.
That's kind of interesting.
Yeah, that's just kid stuff. Check this out, okay? The word for the Garden of Eden, Kedem. Numerical translation, 144. Now, the value of tree of knowledge, all right, in the garden, right? Eitz HaChayim, 233. 144, 233. And you can take those numbers.
So, the, you know, like the Fibonacci sequence?
Fibonacci
is an Italian mathematician in the 13th century. If you divide 144 into 233, the result approaches theta.
Theta?
Theta. The Greek symbol for golden ratio, golden spiral.
Wow. I never saw that before. That's like that series you find in nature? Like the face of a sunflower?
Wherever the spirals.
You see this math everywhere. Hey, Mac.